Hey guys, welcome back to our channel, the number one place for designers, artists and creators. My name is Laszlo and today I want to show you how you can make one of those Instagram carousel slides using Adobe Photoshop. Now this tutorial is for people who are serious enough about content creation and have some basic Photoshop knowledge, but we're not gonna jump onto very advanced territories here. I'll do my best to keep everything very clear and concise. With these easy settings, anyone can create a highly customized carousel slide, so let's jump straight in. Now first of all, let's get through the technical details to set our canvas up. Instagram allows you to post images that are ideally 1080 pixels by 1080 pixels square shaped images. So what you want to do is keep the height of your canvas at 1080 and then multiply 1080 by the number of slides you want to have in your carousel to get your width. I am making a 10 slide post, which is the maximum number of slides allowed on Instagram. So my width is 10 times 1080 pixels, which is 10,800 pixels in total. Then what you want to do is set up guides so you know where your image borders are going to be. Click on View and go down to New Guide Layout. Here all you have to do is set up columns of 10 or however many slides you are going to make. Now make sure there is no margin setup and then click OK. After that, look for this Slice tool in the toolbar, then up here click on Slices from Guides. This will make sure that we will be able to save our images individually once we are done. Now that it's all set up, let's get to designing and talk about the general structure of this thing. I like to think of these little slideshows as little digital storybooks. So to resemble the book format, we have to have a cover to begin with, which will have a clear title and an explanation of what your followers are about to see in your post. Now towards the end, we will have a conclusion, moral of the story kind of thing that summarizes the message of your carousel. And at the very end, we will make a little index page, which will cite your sources if you have any, as well as include your own links, you know, like your website, account name, maybe an image of yourself as well. That's the place to do a little self-promo. Now, however many slides you have left in the middle between these borders, that is the space you actually build your post in. Now, with this, naturally, you can do whatever you want, so I'm not going to tell you what to make your post about, but let me just give you a couple pointers. First of all, only make a carousel if you feel like this is the suitable format for your content. With carousels, you have to tell some kind of a story. If there is no story, you might as well just make a one image post. And there is nothing more disappointing than sliding through a carousel that doesn't have enough content to back it up. These things can be quite time consuming to make, and let's be honest, on social media we all have the attention span of a goldfish, so make sure that you're not wasting your or anyone else's time. Think of what your carousel concept is and why is it suitable for this format. My example here is going to be a gallery of logos showcasing past work I have done for some small businesses, and my core message, what I'm trying to communicate to my followers, is to support small enterprises. Now it does help if you already have your content ready before you begin building your post. You don't have to have everything prepared down to a T. In fact, as you start playing around, you will probably get more inspired, ideas will come to you to elevate your design, but have some material on the ready to start with. Obviously, I had my logos ready and then I had this idea of making my carousel look like an actual art gallery with visitors. So what I did is I found this Photoshop mockup of an art gallery display with walls and these picture frames, which I wanted to use as the base of my concept. Then I looked for a bunch of stock images of people visiting art galleries and museums. I downloaded most of these from Unsplash, which is a royalty-free image sourcing site. Now to put these in, I have got rid of their background. You can do this in a number of different ways. The Magic Eraser tool is quite good at deleting stuff. I also like the Magic Wand tool to make selections and then delete them. The Quick Selection tool also does the job. With this one though, what I find is it's better to actually select the people, the person first, and then go select inverse and then delete the background. And you can also mask things off if that's what you're used to doing. Now once I had these elements sorted, I started adding more text, some info about these brands and links. It goes without saying that if you do something like this, make sure that your work is properly sourced, all the links are accurate, look out for typos, and always be respectful with mentioning other people and brands. Don't spread hate or bad vibes, please. After this, I added some slides that further convey my core message. which in my case was to always champion creative thinking and people who were stepping out of the line with their unique ideas, starting businesses, trying to make the world a better place, because at the end of the day, and I truly believe this, that these will be the key people who will solve the toughest challenges the world throws at us. And that's a good point I want to raise as well, that you should always be making content that you believe in. Use your past experiences and personality so the post will project your genuine self. Now, at the very end of my slides, I put my own branding in place, my logo, my website, my Instagram username, that kind of thing. I think it is quite a useful technique to constantly zoom in and out to check if the design is working. Zoom out and see if the whole piece looks consistent enough so it feels like a set, and then zoom in and see the slides one by one to check if they flow well. Every slide should have some important stuff on them. Do not make filler slides. Instagram does allow you to have 10 slides per carousel, but if you only need 5 to give out a message, then use 5. It is also a good idea to tease the next slide in all the images so people will feel compelled to keep sliding. The way I did mine, you see these picture frames, you can always see the next one coming up just on the corner of my slide. But I also made sure that the actual content, the logos within these picture frames are not cut, so people can actually stop within the slideshow and look at them individually. Now, once I got to this stage, I felt like there is too much white space in the design. So what I did is I brought in the logos once more and overlaid them on these walls as well. I blew them up and took the opacity down and make it look like they are sort of graffiti style wall paintings. You know, just to smuggle in a bit more color, a bit more life into this thing. And as the last step in my design process, I was refining my work. I made sure that the hierarchy of my layers is correct, that the people are in the foreground, fixed little mistakes where the images join up, as well as format the text to the point I was happy with it. Now, text might be the most important design element on these slides, so don't feel guilty to spend a lot of time on it. Play with the sizes and don't mix too many different fonts together. Stick to one, maybe two, that are clear and easy to read. I'm using this one called Bebas in most of my self-branding work. Now, this happens to be one of the most popular carousel fonts as well. Also, make sure that the colors work in your favor. If your slides are dark, use light colored text, and if you're like me and most of your images are white, use dark shades. Remember that legibility is king. Okay, once you're done, we have to save these out. Now, it took me a while to figure out the right way to do this, so pay attention closely. Go to File, Export, and Save for Web. Now here, make sure that your format is JPEG and that the quality is at the maximum. Now for some reason, when I tried to do this just by clicking on Save here, I ended up with GIFs instead of JPEGs. So what I did is I held down my mouse in this little window and dragged it all the way across the right until all my pieces were selected. Now I went to save these out, and even here, when it's asking for a name, I put JPEG instead of GIF. It sounds a little overcomplicated, but this is what worked for me. And there you go, you should have your individual images ready. Now just find a way to get these on your phone. I do this by uploading them to cloud software. OneDrive is my go-to. Then I download them from there onto my phone. And now all that's left to do is post it.
Now, there are many other ways to create these carousel slides, of course. If you're a non-designer, you probably would use a template-based app like Canva on your phone to create these. And if you are a professional, you would probably jump onto InDesign, Illustrator, and Photoshop to combine these software to create your slides. But I do recognize a lot of you guys would probably be in between these two groups. People who are serious enough about creating their own content and they want to stand out from the template-based look, but at the same time either don't have the time or the resources to the whole Adobe package. Hence, I wanted to show you that you can do the whole thing from beginning to end in Photoshop if you have to, and create a carousel slide that looks exactly the way you want it to look. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please join our little design tribe if you enjoy our content. We touch on graphics, illustration, branding, interior design, architecture, and everything in between. Take care, guys, and I'll see you this time next week with another video. Bye!